Good morning. We already discussed the general magnitudes and directions of forces acting on a ball moving in a vertical circle in non-uniform circular motion, like this. Today we are going to find an equation for the force of tension in the string. Bobby, please read the problem, and Bo, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A ball of mass M on the end of a string of length capital L moves in a vertical circle with a non-constant angular speed omega. The string forms an angle theta with the vertical as shown. Determine the tension in the rope in terms of M, L, omega, theta, and known constants.
Our knowns are mass M, rope length capital L, angular speed omega, and angle theta. And the force of tension equals question mark. That's it.
Right. Billy, what should we do next?
We need to draw the free body diagram, but you kind of already had it there for us just a few moments ago.
Yeah, I know. That's actually from last time. Please just tell me the forces in the free body diagram.
Okay. The force of gravity is straight down, and the force of tension is in toward the center of the circle.
And what should we do next?
Eventually, we are going to sum the forces in the in direction, or the direction along the radius of the circle, which is where the string is. And we are going to sum the forces in a direction perpendicular to the in direction, which is the tangential direction, because it is tangent to the circle and in the direction of the motion of the ball. So we need to break forces into components in the in and tangential directions.
Actually, the force of tension is always pointed in the in direction, so we do not need to break that force into components.
Right, so we only need to break the force of gravity into components in the in and tangential directions. Actually, the force of gravity component in the in direction is actually directed outward at that point. So I guess that is the outward component of the force of gravity. Oh, and you can see, because the outward component of the force of gravity is along the radius and the force of gravity is straight down, that the angle theta in the vector addition triangle, which has the components of the force of gravity in it, is the same angle theta as shown in the problem. So sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse, or the tangential component of the force of gravity over the force of gravity. Therefore, the tangential component of the force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta. And cosine theta equals adjacent over hypotenuse, or the outward component of the force of gravity over the force of gravity. Therefore, the outward component of the force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta. Oh, and we should redraw the free body diagram with the components of the force of gravity rather than the force of gravity.
Now we can sum the forces in the tangential direction. The only force acting in the tangential direction is the force of gravity tangential, which then equals mass times tangential acceleration. That means mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta equals mass times tangential acceleration, and
everybody brought mass to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
Bo, please keep going.
Now, we know the tangential acceleration of the ball equals acceleration due to gravity times sine theta. I guess we put that in our equation holster.
Equation holster!
Bobby, what now?
Now we sum the forces in the in direction. So net force in the in direction equals force of tension, which is positive because forces acting inward are positive, minus outward force of gravity, minus because forces which act outward are negative. All that equals mass times the acceleration in the in direction, which is centripetal acceleration.
The force of gravity component which acts outward in the bottom semicircle of the path acts inward instead when the ball is in the top semicircle of the path. How do we account for that?
When the ball is in the top semicircle of the path, theta is between 90 and 270 degrees, and the cosine of an angle between 90 and 270 degrees is negative, which changes the direction of the force from outward to inward, and the equations still work.
Cool. That makes sense. Thanks.
You are welcome.
So, force of tension equals the outward force of gravity plus mass times a centripetal acceleration. We have stuff we can substitute in for those. Mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta plus mass times radius times angular speed squared. And the radius equals capital L, the length of the string. So the force of tension equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta plus mass times length times angular speed squared.
Very nice, y'all. Now, I do want to point out that the equation we just derived matches what we previously showed visually. The term mass times length times angular speed squared is always positive. And the term mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta oscillates back and forth between positive and negative values as theta changes. When the ball is at the bottom of the circle, theta equals 0, the cosine of 0 equals 1, and that term has its maximum value. Therefore, the force of tension is at its maximum value when the ball is at the bottom of the circle. When the ball is at the top of the circle, theta equals 180 degrees, the cosine of 180 degrees equals negative 1, and that term has its minimum value. Therefore, the force of tension is at its minimum value when the ball is at the top of the circle.
Cool. That is actually what we see in the animation.
Yep. But notice we can also solve for the minimum angular speed to keep the ball moving in a circle. Bo, how do we do that?
We are solving for the minimum angular speed to keep the ball moving in a circle. If the ball moves any slower than the minimum angular speed, it won't make it all the way to the top to form a circular path. Then when the ball is at the top of the circle at that minimum speed, the force of tension is reduced down to zero and the angle is 180 degrees. So we just substitute those values into the equation for the force of tension. We get 0 equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times the cosine of 180 degrees plus mass times length times angular speed squared. We can rearrange that equation to get negative mass times acceleration due to gravity times negative 1 equals mass times length times angular speed squared. And
everybody brought mass to the party.
Mass to the party. Everybody brought mass.
Bo, please keep going. Deja vu?
We get acceleration due to gravity equals length times angular speed squared, and we can solve for angular speed. The minimum angular speed to keep the ball moving in a vertical circle equals the square root of the quantity acceleration due to gravity over the length of the rope.
That is exactly what we got for the minimum speed to keep water in the vertically revolving bucket. That's cool.
Yes, Billy, that is correct. Now, I do want to make it absolutely clear that, as we showed last time, the angular speed of the ball decreases as it moves up toward the top of the circle and increases as it moves down away from the top of the circle. Therefore, this minimum angular speed we are talking about is only at the singular point, which is at the very top of the path, when the string is completely vertical. Before and after the ball is at the top of the path, the angular speed of the ball will be larger than this minimum angular speed.
Hold up, Mr. P.
Yes, Bo?
We never used the equation I put in the equation holster. The tangential acceleration of the ball equals acceleration due to gravity times the sine of theta. What's up with that?
Bo, you are correct. We never did end up using that equation that you put in our equation holster. It turns out that summing the forces in the tangential direction was an unnecessary step when solving this problem.
Oh, come on.
Sometimes we end up doing steps which are correct, however, not necessary when solving for what is asked for in the problem. That's just how solving problems sometimes goes.
No, that's not fair.
Yeah. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.